record it, drop, you can't ignore it. I'm transforming now, these cars and planes, I'm always boarding. Just out touring down in Charlotte like I play for Hornets. When I'm performing, never boring, now you can't afford it.
What's up, friends, and welcome back to my channel. So let's talk sauna blankets. Well, specifically, the higher dose sauna blanket. I know there are a ton of options on the market right now, but I went with this one because A, it's been around the longest, and you guys have been asking me to review it for like a year. So let's finally do this thing. Now, coincidentally, I got this blanket back in June, around the same time my full sunlight and sauna arrived. I know, terrible timing on my part, but it actually turned out for the best because I had a chance to test them both out side by side. And so I'm really excited to give you a full overview of how the two compare in terms of temperature, sweating, comfort, EMFs, and all my biometric data, including things like heart rate and calories burned. Now, that being said, I am certainly not going to suggest that a $500 blanket comes anywhere close to the quality or experience that you get from a $5,000 home sauna. But there are a lot of pros and cons to both. And so if you do not have the space or the budget for a full sauna, could something like this blanket be a good sweat-inducing alternative? Well, stick around as I plan to answer this and a heck of a lot more all about the higher dose V3 infrared sauna blanket. So let's dive straight into the review, and we'll start with specs. This blanket is super compact. It's about 6 feet long, 2.5 feet wide, and it folds up pretty easily, so you can stash it away under a couch or a bed when you're not using it. And I was actually surprised it really didn't weigh a lot either. It's about 15 pounds. And the reason I mention this has to do with traveling. So one of the downsides of having a home sauna is, well, you can't really take it with you on long trips, and it's kind of a headache to ship or sell if you do plan to move. More on that in a little bit. But you can fly with one of these blankets because, as you'll see here, it does actually fit into your standard size suitcase. Yes, it doesn't leave you a ton of extra packing space, but it is totally doable. Now, moving on to setup and actual prep time. To turn the unit on, you attach this controller to the base of the blanket and then plug the other end of the cord into your outlet. And if you do live in the US, this model plugs into any regular outlet like you see here. But this is not the case with most full infrared saunas like the Sunlighten, which do require a dedicated 120 volt, 20 amp circuit and outlet for your power supply. So just something to note. After you press the on button, you'll see there's a couple of different preset options to choose from, ranging from level 1 to level 8. And I will talk about just how hot these different levels get in just a sec. But in terms of preheating, the company recommends 15 minutes or so, and I tested it. I actually found that to be pretty accurate, as you'll see here. And just for reference, that's also about a quarter of the time it takes to fully preheat my Sunlight and sauna to around 157 degrees. Obviously, the blanket surface area is a lot smaller, meaning there is less space to heat up, but just something to think about if prep time is a big factor for you. And on a similar token, since the blanket does come pre-assembled, you really don't have to worry about the hassle of building anything from the ground up, which is a huge plus, and it does save a hell of a lot of time up front. So getting all the specs out of the way, now let's move on to some of the fun stuff, including my own experience. What to wear, how long to stay in, and how much will you actually sweat during one of these sessions. So if we look at it step by step, step one, before you even step foot into this thing, you're gonna wanna put on some loose-fitting clothing. And most importantly, socks. I know, it sounds like the complete opposite of what you'd expect from a normal sauna session. I mean, the point is kind of like to strip down, not layer up. But in a traditional sauna, chances are your skin's pressed against the wood surface only. In the blanket, however, your body's making direct contact with the heating mechanism. So having that extra buffer between your skin and the blanket is really meant to keep your skin safe, especially at some of those higher levels. And in fact, if you do plan to use this thing at its highest setting, I would even throw down a towel or two just to create some extra skin protection, and it's also better for sweat absorption. So then step two, is actually getting in. And if you've ever stepped foot in a sleeping bag, then the higher dose blanket should totally be a breeze. You open it up halfway, slide your body in, making sure to leave space for your head to stick out at the top, and then you close yourself in by attaching the open side to this Velcro layer in the middle. I mean, it's definitely nice to have a little assistance, but it's also totally doable on your own. And up to you whether to keep your arms in or out. I mean, I personally like to keep them in for the full body experience, but if you're planning to read or something, then you probably want to go hands-free. And as a quick pro tip, it really helps to get your total environment set up before the session. That means headphones on, your water bottle nearby, and maybe even Netflix queued up and ready to go. Because once you're perfectly sandwiched into this sauna burrito, you're not really going to be able to get up and move around much. Trust me. So that leads us to step three, which is the total session itself. And let's talk about heat, including the temperature settings and just how much you can expect to sweat during one of these sessions. So if you're new, they do recommend that you start at a level 4 or 5, which gets up to about 125 degrees, at least according to my infrared thermometer. And honestly, this is probably a good place to start if you don't have much experience with saunas and heat stress. But because I have been saunaing for a couple of years now, I went straight to level 8, and oh boy, does this thing actually get hot. So the temperature range at this level is somewhere between 145 to 150, which really didn't seem too crazy at first, but when your body's packed into such a tight space like this, you really do feel the intensity of the heat, especially at your feet. Hence the whole socks disclaimer. And I'll admit that heat can get a bit unbearable the longer that you stay in. Not unlike a traditional infrared sauna. But the difference here is that in a sauna cabin, not only is the heat more widely dispersed, but you can also easily move your body or change positions to help with some of this heat stress. In the blanket though, you have nowhere to go other than out. Yes, the temperature ranges themselves might be similar for both devices, but when it comes down to heat intensity and overall comfort, well, the two could not be more dissimilar. And I'll talk a little bit more about this when we discuss my final thoughts in just a sec. But first, let's talk sweat. You might be wondering, well, how long does it take to actually start sweating in one of these things? The answer is gonna obviously vary for everyone, but for me, I'd say it started between that 15 and 20 minute mark if I'm getting in at a level 8. Now with the traditional sunlight in cabin, I am pretty much drenched like 10 minutes into it, and then I tend to hit my limit by that 25 to 30 minute mark. So I'd say if you really like to sweat profusely, expect your blanket sessions to be a little bit longer, probably closer to 45 minutes or maybe even an hour. Now there is an auto shut off after the 1 hour mark, mainly as a safety precaution, but you also wouldn't want to stay in the blanket much longer than that anyway, because the law of diminishing return really does apply to any good stressor on the body, from heat stress to cold therapy. And if you want to learn a little bit more about what I'm talking about here in terms of homeostasis, then I highly recommend you check out some of the links I include in the resources section below. Now, in terms of metrics, I also took a look back at the data I collected from my Apple Watch during my higher dose sessions and then compared them to the data from my sunlighting sessions. And so here is a snapshot of what those average numbers looked like. So for a typical 30 minute sauna session in the sunlight and at max heat, on average, I burned 123 total calories. My average heart rate hovered around 104, and my peak heart rate was around 140. Fast forward to my sessions with the higher dose blanket. Granted, I was staying a little bit longer, about 35 to 40 minutes at max heat. And here I was burning around 103 calories on average. My average heart rate was around 95 to 96, and then my max heart rate was somewhere around 115 to 116. So not a huge difference when it comes to your average heart rate and calories burned, but the peak heart rate difference, 140 versus 115, is pretty significant and maybe the result of just having more of my body exposed to the heat, or it could also be that I was just getting up and moving around the cabin more, leading to a bigger and probably faster spike in my heart rate. And before we get to my final takeaways, let's first address EMFs. Now on their website, Higher Dose bills this as a low EMF device, but don't include any other details around that. So I tested it and I found the magnetic field readings were actually pretty low, around 0.2 to 0.3, which is similar to the range you'd get in the sunlight and sauna. For the electrical readings, however, it's kind of a mixed bag. Some parts were 56 volts per meter, but others spiked well into the hundreds, especially at the bottom near the electrical plug. But again, this was very similar to the readings I was getting in my sunlight as well. And at the end of the day, these devices are powered by electricity, so you do have to expect some low levels of EMF regardless of the types of fabrics they use to kind of mitigate this. And finally, we get to price and whether the higher dose blanket is actually worth the money. And I think the answer to that, well, it really depends on how much you actually plan to use it. So if right now you're spending anywhere from $40 to $60 for an infrared sauna session at your local spa, and by the way, higher dose charges like $65 for a 1 hour session at their New York City facilities, well, that's like the equivalent of 10 to 12 sessions for the total cost of this blanket. Now, granted, it is not the same exact experience, but you'll still get a good sweat in, and it's certainly more time effective and maybe even cost effective in the long run. But if you are still on the fence, then let's quickly take a look at the pros and cons. So hopefully you can finally decide for yourself if this is right for you. On the plus side, the blanket's design is pretty comfortable. You are laying down, you have the option to be hands-free and do other things while you're in the sauna. And if you don't like breathing in hot air from a traditional sauna, this could be a great option because your head can rest outside of the device. It's also super easy to set up and even quicker to preheat than a traditional sauna, about 15 minutes versus an hour. And finally, this was probably the biggest consideration for me, it's portable. So you can stow it away easily and you can travel with it. We are potentially moving again later this year. And so that does make things tricky when it comes to having a full home sauna. But with something like this, it is a no-brainer. And so there's just that consideration to maybe take into account before buying something like this. Moving on to the downsides, and I think it's important to remember that this is still a blanket. So you're gonna be somewhat in a confined space with very limited mobility during these sessions. It also doesn't get as hot as my traditional infrared sauna. We're talking 170 versus 155, and the heat isn't as evenly distributed. Some areas get hotter than others, especially near the bottom where your feet are. You also do have to clean it after every use, otherwise it's just gonna get really gross. There's also no timer on the device, and that really made it hard for me to gauge just how long I was in there, and no return policy. So once you've popped this bad boy out of its box and you've tried it out for just one session, well, you're not getting a refund. Now, taking all that into account, I would have to say that even though I personally prefer the traditional sauna experience and will 10 out of 10 always choose the sunlight over the higher dose, that's certainly not to say the blanket is bad. And again, if you don't have the space or the budget for a full sauna, it does get hot and you will get a good sweat in. But just remember, at the end of the day, it is still just a temperature controlled sleeping bag. And I know that probably sounds really harsh, but it's important to set expectations when it does come to something like this. Because I'll admit, I've seen their marketing. It's fantastic. They've done a bang up job with all their claims about celebrity endorsements, glowing skin, and getting a workout in without actually having to work out. But to me, it's a lot of hype, and I always go straight to the data, but there have been no actual published studies to support or deny any of their claims. So as a conscious consumer, you might want to take all that fancy goop jargon with a grain of salt and really ask yourself the question, do the pros outweigh the cons? And does this device seem like something I'm really going to use that often that will potentially save me money in the long run? And so if the answer is yes, then heck, I'd say give it a shot. And if you do have one of these blankets, even if it's not higher dose, and you want to chime in on the discussion, please leave a comment below. I mean, it helps me out, it helps out the rest of the community, and I'm very excited to get your guys' thoughts on this whole sauna blanket craze. And so if you like this video, give it a thumbs up. It really does help, and maybe even share it with a friend. And then for all the other stuff, the subscribe, the bell, you guys know the drill. And until then, I cannot wait to catch you on the next one.